pay you off? How can they give you hush money and you still be part of this culture? How the fuck does that work? Let's listen to what the fuck going on.
Tory Lanez is on Instagram threatening to expose Interscope Records if they don't stop playing with them. I'm going to show you. So it says, Interscope Records, if you all stop playing with me, I'm going to expose what's really going on in that fucking building. He said, at Interscope, y'all play with me if you want to. Let's play. Y'all got the right fucking one.
Did you know that becoming a rapper is the number one cause of death amongst young black men? Have you ever wondered why the incarceration and murder of rappers is so accepted and somewhat celebrated amongst today's society? Today, we're going to explore an example of this phenomenon. Welcome to The Rap Trap, hosted by AYO CONSACO.
Welcome back to The Rap Trap. I am AYO CONSACO, fearless leader of AYO Nation and the Me and Two movement. And of course, this is In Hindsight. And we're gonna do this show in reverse. Usually we talk about some shit that's already happened. Now we're about to talk about why the fuck something hasn't happened. Tory Lanez seems to be going through label trouble. And with him going through the label trouble, like every label person is going to, at some point in your career, you're gonna have issues with the label because you're gonna feel like they should still be treating you like they did when you first came out, when you were blazing hot. You thought that they were gonna forever and ever, no matter what. You really thought them people fuck with you. Like, when I told y'all that labels were giving artists dope, motherfuckers overlooked it, act like motherfucking ain't said it. Then you find out Juice WRLD died. When I told y'all the process of an artist coming into the industry, this game, especially right now, Tory Lanez came in a little bit before this expedient fucking process, before it is the whole artist career lifetime got fucking expedited to 6 months. Tory Lanez is looking at his social media. People still treat him like a superstar when they see him and shit like that. But with all these other acts coming out and shit like that, it's just natural for you to not get that same attention from the label, from the people, from everybody that you used to. And artists have a very hard time coping with this decrease in love and what they thought was affection at their label. And now he's throwing this hissy fit because he wanna come out like he wanna have the same power over the label that he used to have when he was on fire. Because looking at his social media, and they seem to be like ecstatic about him, and he's not realizing that it's the fucking internet. Let's listen to what. But before we do that, I want to say this. Is that shit on?
Okay, so.
Okay, it is on. So the nigga is angry with the label because he feel like they're the reason why, and that's also natural for artists. The label hold me back. That's why my shit fucking up like this. That's why my numbers is going down and all this. Nah, it's just a natural fucking decrease. Quiet down.
Thank you.
This is totally natural. This day was always going to come. The day where motherfuckers aren't fucking with you, Tory Lanez, Drake, Chris Brown, this NBA YoungBoy, Kodak Black. They're not going. Future, Master P, 112, Jagged Edge, fucking Destiny's Child, Beyonce, Adele. Let me stop right there. Cause over there, you can eat forever. Crazy. But so now you're not getting that love and all that shit. You feel like you're being depraved of love and they not letting you get your way as much. So now, just like a bitch, you go to the internet because you're going through what every other artist went through. You thought you were smarter than their team of fucking lawyers? See, and that's what I'm gonna say to you before we play the audio. When I be speaking on this label shit and just the industry in general, now I can't just look at it like I'm just pro artist, because after dealing with these artists, and this is anybody in the industry behind the scenes. Videographers, graphic designers, animators, producers, beat makers, there's a difference. Did I say videographers? I'm sure I did. Promoters, managers, road managers, just the people behind the scenes. Niggas who interview niggas, you ask like and talk to them about these artists, and they'll tell you like these motherfuckers feel entitled. The hardest thing that you'll do with an artist is have them believe that they're not where they think they are, and they have to pay money to get shit done. It's like, my nigga, you have no fucking problem. We're not getting. All that shit is for the rap school, Conseco's Rap School, on the Tactical Operations channel. That link is in the description box. Make sure you go there if you're an artist or anyone in the music industry. I had to do a channel where I speak directly to the artists to let them know how fucking remedial their way of thinking is. So, after being someone who's been promoting artists for as long as I have, I know that they can feel entitled, and on top of being entitled, they can be extremely selfish, i.e. the Carl Crawford and Meg Thee Stallion situation, where I brought you up from nothing, and then as soon as you get spotlight, you run to try to get yourself out this deal before I recoup the money, time, and energy that I put into you. What kind of bullshit is this? And it's, my nigga, it's just very simple. If you won the lottery today and say, I'm gonna start me a label up. You're not starting a label. If you're not gonna just be broke like the majority of people who win a lottery within 5 years. If you're having a business mind, your mind is, I'm gonna spend this much to make this much. I'm not spending this much because I wanna see you shine. I'm not spending this much to make this much back. I'm spending this much to get this much. And on top of the money that I have to spend to get this artist off the ground in today's climate, the time and energy that I have to put into you, me being away from my family, me having to answer the phone late at night and get this hooked up, get that hooked up, the business relationships that I have to create in order for you to have outlets. I do all of that. You do all of that for the artist. You won $5 million. You start me a label, you call it fucking Rap World Records. And you got a nigga from whatever city you from, and you put over $10,000 in him, from his image to the beats to playing this shit on the radio, the fucking internet shows, promotion on different internet shows, in the club, all kind of shit. Okay, not to mention you gotta go to these places with them, t-shirts, all kind of shit. Flyers in the street, you had to pass out the flyers to get the shit out, or pay the street team. You do all that, and now the labels start knocking, and he take the first deal. Like, oh yeah, appreciate it, my nigga. Like, whoa. We got good news and we got bad news. Hold on. But all my habitual donators that always hear that name during the AYO Nation donation conversation that we do every third Sunday, I salute you before we do anything. To take your hard earned and to put it in something that you fuck with, it motivates me beyond words. Period. Love. The good news is this. I'm gonna continue to do the How to Identify Nothing Ass Bitch series. Of course, you know it's AYO Nation exclusive series, so you have to go to patreon.com and become a patron in order to watch it. And once you become a patron, you'll be able to see all of the other unreleased episodes that I couldn't put on YouTube. Every Monday, we go live on the Big Face Podcast channel at 7:30. A lot of y'all be late than a motherfucker, but we go live every Monday at 7:30. If you're a lieutenant, you'll be given the privilege to call in and state your opinion at any point in time during the broadcast. At 6:45, you'll be given a call-in number on your Patreon account, and we just go from there. For all my new people, if you want the Are You Serious t-shirt, it's $15. The Big Facts Podcast t-shirt is $15. The Men 2 t-shirt is $20, and the Big Facts Podcast Scullies are $10. Go to paypal.me/Are You Serious 10. Address, size, color, and what shirt you want. It's time for the bad news. The bad news is no one watches sponsored videos. So if you're a rapper and you thinking that I'm gonna get an IG sponsorship or I'm gonna get a Facebook sponsorship, nobody's watching the shit. So the numbers that they're telling you that you have are bullshit. And you know that bullshit because when you post after you did your sponsorship, your shit plummets. Even when you are running the sponsorship, your fucking YouTube numbers are bullshit. They're bullshit. Stop playing with yourself. Here on this show, where we do not accept trash music, we do not accept homosexual music, and we don't accept that mumble rap bullshit. The prices for promotion start at $200. They go up to $2,000, depending on how much exposure you want. They start there. So if you don't have $200, there's no reason to come this way. If your music is not up to par, there's no reason to come this way. I explain the packages as soon as you come in the inbox and say, hey, I got my budget together, what the packages are. I'm not putting out no fucking price sheet so you can pass that shit to your fucking homosexual homeboy and send him my fucking way. Ain't no fucking price sheet because everybody can't get on this show. I want to see your motherfucking profile. I want to check, see what the fuck I'm fucking with. This show has integrity. That's why we rock the way we rock. But you keep paying that $25, $35 to a fucking sponsorship, which no one sees. They scroll right past it. And you'll be a fucking 50-year-old rapper. And that's just what it is. Get shit together, be home. Whoa. Hold on. Hold up, my nigga. And that's why it's so hard to be friends with someone that you're doing business with. And if you're a label owner, you are doing business with that artist. Y'all aren't friends like that. Y'all are business partners first. And they will use that against you a lot of times. Oh, nigga, shit, nigga, if it's really from the heart, my nigga, then shit. No, hold, before you go any further, it was from the heart, but it was also from the pocket. I need my pockets reimbursed. But if it's from the heart, my nigga, shit, you know, you want to see me do good, my nigga. You want to see me come up. I'm going to go and do this right here, and I'm going to have you. Like, hold, my nigga, look here. Look here, my nigga. I just spent 10 racks of my money and all this time. Like, we already talked about this shit, like, how we gonna split the money and shit like that. I even gave you a 50-50 split. I was gonna take my money the slow way because we were gonna grind together. And now as soon as Rock Nation, Interscope, or whoever the fuck, they didn't even put no money on the fucking deal. You just being a prostitute for a name. Not to mention, I'm just out here, nigga, please. And this is what a contract is for. So in a lot of ways, you have to understand a label. Hey, good rapper, I'm going to advance you this much, and we're gonna put this much into you because we're trying to make this much. And what's to say that they won't spend what they'll say is, and I say they'll say because studio time can be $25 an hour or $1,000 an hour, depending on how they want to price their shit. Video can be $200 or $1,000,000, depending on how they price it. And that's how they really bury you. You'll never come the fuck out. And that's why you have to be mindful of these things before you enter into this game. And this is another reason why they don't want anyone over 19. This is why I tell artists on Conseco's Rap School, on Tactical Operations, the link's in the description. And if you go to, you're going to have to hit, if you look for it on YouTube, you're going to have to, just go in the fucking description box and hit the shit. But if you do it, it's going to be Tactical Operations AYO, because Tactical Operations is going to bring up some army shit. But I tell artists, if you over 19, my nigga, don't even be thinking about getting no deal. You over 25, you pretty much need to stop rapping. Though that's me being honest with you. That's how fucked up your odds are. Yes, it will be some niggas, and yes, it will be some exceptions, but you're probably not going to be it. You need to be focused. They want a young motherfucker that they can fuck over. This is the game. This is the game. But that's the reason why they would want it like that, so that they can put you in a situation you'll be naive, record label, oh my God, and you go down the road for whatever the fuck they give you. But here's the thing with Tory Lanez. So we having all these situations with these labels and niggas getting fucked over and just all these different labels giving niggas dope and just all this evil shit. Just, I'm talking about evil shit. Rap trap. Evidence. Why in the fuck are you speaking without speaking on what the fuck is going on? If there's some evil shit going on, first off, why the fuck you ain't speak on it? This is my shit. If there's some evil shit going on, why in the fuck ain't you speak on it when you first seen it, when it first happened? If they fucking niggas over, why the fuck haven't you been spoke on it? And why is it that they can now give you some money or give you your way and you won't speak on it? And ain't no telling how many niggas will fall victim to the fucking rap trap, to Interscope, which is all the rest of the fucking labels, all on practice the same way. Why wouldn't you speak? How can they pay you off? How can they give you hush money and you still be part of this culture? How the fuck does that work? Let's listen to what the fuck going on.
Tory Lanez is on Instagram threatening to expose Interscope Records if they don't stop playing with them. I'm gonna show you. So it says, Interscope Records, if y'all don't stop playing with me, I'm gonna expose what's really going on in that fucking building. He said, at Interscope, y'all play with me if you want to. Let's play. Y'all got the right fucking one. So Tory Lanez blasting Interscope, letting them know he's ready to expose. He's either clout chasing, quote unquote, trolling, whatever you want to call it, or he really is, you know, ready to spill the beans. Let's see what people in the comments are saying. He said, this is going to be fun, though. I promise. Rich the kids in here. He said, I'm telling you. Chill, bro. I ain't trying to see you killed. He said, that's the difference. I don't care. My integrity, respect, and the path of light that I show the generation after me is more important than this life. That dude's is scared to lose. That's deep, actually. I don't know what's going on if this is actually...
First. Before I even get started, I learned my lesson of just talking to the goddamn camera and just believing that that bitch is still recording. No, sir. And we gonna make sure. First off, this is the reason why, man, when you're dealing with people that are untraveled, haven't lived life, I can't even say, like, just, you know, gangsters and shit like that, street nigga, because there's some dumbass niggas who really did crimes, you know what I'm saying, that's online and ain't giving no type of shit, nothing. I think it's a balance, but my nigga, I don't, like, how is that deep? He's saying, Interscope, you better give me what I want, or I'ma tell on y'all. And then he's saying, my integrity is all that matters, and the generations after me, they gonna flourish, because, hope, my nigga, you acting like you said something. My nigga, you ain't said shit. You gave the people an offer. You told them, hey, shit, you better pay me or give me what I want. Or, and of course, it's about money. Give me some money and I won't tell on y'all, and I let y'all keep fucking niggas over. I let y'all keep doing the evil shit that y'all doing. The evil shit y'all doing is cool. I won't say nothing as long as you pay me. And then you talk about integrity? And then whoever the fuck this is talking about this deep.
I'm just reading these comments for the first time too, so I'm seeing them as you are. So that's kind of deep. I wonder, you know, is Tory Lanez really on some shit where he's like, fuck the industry, he's trying to do his thing, and he's tired of this shit, he's ready to expose it. Let's see what other people are saying. He finna expose the Illuminati. Let me...
He's getting ready to? Why do you have to give a preamble? Why do you have to teleport your punches? Like, if it's something fucked up that's going on in that building, how is it that they can...
Go grab my popcorn, put them on blast. Just be careful, bro. Talk to your attorneys, lawyers first. Tell it all. I mean, what is there really to tell that we haven't heard before, though? To be honest with you, I'm sure whatever Tory Lanez is sitting on as far as it...
All right, so... That might be a good point, what he just said. Like, what is he sitting on? Maybe he thinks he's going to say something. But I'm saying the whole thing about it is you're making it seem like there is something dark. There is something afoot. And you're letting the whole world know that you can be paid off. I don't understand how this isn't being seen. How is this not? And this is so important to how we continue to get fucked over. There are people who know how fucked up situations are, but because they don't want to fuck up their situation and their money, oh, I ain't gonna hurt you. I'm just gonna get along. They keep paying me. I ain't gonna say nothing. And then when you do say something, you look like the sour, tired ass rapper because your time is over with now. We're not gonna get political, but it's like, and because I really don't want to use this example because I don't know the specifics and there's so much going on around it, but let's just use Kaepernick for example. While you're still in your prime, still able to play, you fuck up your whole career for something that's righteous. Then you can speak about integrity, but you don't threaten to give information that can help. That's, so how big is that word right now? If we're talking about our music, this hip-hop industry, the hip-hop music industry, help is a extremely big word right now. There is not a question on whether or not we need it. I got a fucking story from some nigga out of fucking, I think, Carolina. They gave this nigga a fucking, he got a bank job. This nigga done hit them folks for $88,000. And this nigga go straight to the internet with the goddamn money. We need help right now. We need somebody on the inside right now. And I've said this before. When the bullshit was going on with Kaepernick, I said LeBron should be sitting. Steph Curry should be sitting. All the big names should be sitting the fuck down. Not the nigga that's on the sideline and ain't really, you know, got that star power. No, the big names. But we can never get the people while they have their biggest soapbox, while they have the biggest fucking platform to get them to speak and say, hey, right now, this is what's going on. Not because I'm mad that my album didn't come out. Not because I'm mad because my sales are declining. The money is fucked up. Not because I'm a, bitter artist. But right now, my career is going well. And I was in Interscope office and saw them. I witnessed it. I saw them push Republican paperwork. I've watched them push pharmaceutical companies within their brand. I've seen the contracts with Interscope and RX, the drug company. These people are working together. We need a insider, we need a whistleblower, but we can't get one because a nigga can always be paid the fuck off. How dare you speak of integrity, sir, in generations to come, when you let it be known that if you get what you want, fuck everybody else. Fuck y'all, y'all gotta figure out. How the fuck we gonna figure it out if we not in the building? I can sit here and say this shit all day. And niggas can see this shit all day. But in order to truly have change, it's going to be have to be somebody from within. You just show these folks your whole fucking hand. If you was really thinking about this shit, you should have been quiet, gathering your fucking information, getting ready to to do a fucking press conference and let this shit be known and blow this shit wide the fuck open. Let them know that they're working with fucking privatized prisons. Speak on the connections. Speak on the legal slavery. Speak on the racism. The written racism, like in contracts, like the way they move around the office. Get footage. But you're not on that. You just want your check and fuck everybody else. But you can go out this bitch. And this is my problem. They'll go out in front of a crowd, in front of, I'm for the kind of culture. What culture do you speak of, my nigga? What culture are you talking about? Stop acting, nigga. You don't give a fuck about no niggas, man. Just stop playing like you do. That's your selling point. I got integrity. How the fuck do you got integrity if you can be bought the fuck off? You have information that can bring down an evil corporation and you won't give it because you waiting on your payment. We need Drake to come out and say it's going on. We need Wiz Khalifa, Wish NBA Youngboy, Kendrick Lamar, J. Cole, well, really, they can't really, but if it was something heavy, we expect for them to bring it forth. People with big platforms that are hot right now. We got Crazy Bone, we got DMX and all these other people speaking on how fucked up this shit is, but we don't have anybody that's moving in the industry right now that will speak out and say, man, look at this shit, I can't be part of this. Furthermore, speaking on integrity, how were you able to see the shit and continue to rock with it? Do you know the definition of integrity? It's what you do when no one's looking. It should have been something, that integrity should have hit you when you seen that homosexual practice go on. Like, oh, I can't fuck with this. And I have to let everyone know that this is what happened when I was at my prime. If you're going to speak on integrity. And if, or like I said, if that's not you, if you not, you, because niggas say, well, you asking the nigga sacrifice his whole bag. No. No, just be NBA Youngboy, be fucking Future, be Drake. Don't speak on integrity. Don't speak on how good of a fucking person you are on the inside, how conscious you are. Kill all that dumb shit and just be a rapper. Here to get my money, give a fuck about whatever. Keep it real. But how dare you publicly prostitute yourself and then speak on integrity when you have information that could help the future generation? These are the people we have to get the fuck away from us. And the people that uphold them, man. The people that up, Joe Budden ain't gonna talk about this shit. He's not gonna talk about it because that's his homeboy. But if you gonna speak about the industry, Joe Budden, let's speak about it. You don't find, like, you're the person, like, you don't think that that's kind of shaky? I'm calling you to arms at this point. Someone else needs to speak on this. No one sees a problem with this.